All right. So today more X-Men are released. I mean, we got till Valentine's Day for release day, which is quite a while. I mean, I don't know about you, but a month seems like forever for me. But more stuff. We had it yesterday. We got it today. I want to talk about it. Again, haven't read anything yet for the reasons of I want to kind of be along the ride with you while we read it if you have already not read it. And if you did, maybe you just hear my opinion. It's whatever. I'm no super HeroClix genius. So it's not like my opinions really matter. Because what I was talking about with the OP kit, Booster Gold stuff, there's a lot of things I liked about it. And then we played HeroClix last night, and I had a buddy that was just like, yeah, you're dead wrong about a couple of them. So it's all opinions. But I mean, I'm just going off what I think and what I see and all that. But so I think it's Eternal Games. It is got a preview. How do you guys get these previews? How do these stores get previews and get these setups? How? Get me hooked up, please. I would love to be like on this. Like people that get their clicks early, and like I go look at their channels and stuff. There's not much going on there or anything like that. So I'm like, how are they getting it? But please hook us up. But anyway, so I believe it's Internal Games. They got three card preview. So we'll start off with Professor X. Says Headmaster X-Men leadership perplexed, but only to target another friendly character with the X-Men keyword. During force instruction, you may include one student card on your force without adding a cost. So a little bit of a Jarvis action there, minus the whole adding three ID cards. I'm not a fan of ID cards. People are very different the way they feel about them. I was kind of happy. I thought we were gonna move away from them, but that's could be a whole nother video. But I just don't. I feel like they're. I'm paying 5 points to bring in a really good click at top dial. That could be a Swiss Army knife on my sidelines of three or four. I just think it's kind of blah. And people are like, oh, but they can die and you get the points from them. You're not gonna kill them unless they're really low clicked. But anyway, so I will not harm another if I can help it. Mind control. When Professor X uses it as range, and he has, was that improved targeting, and he can also shoot through, I believe, is that character? Yeah, shoot through characters. And I thought that was sharpshooter at first. So you can shoot through characters as he does it, which is pretty cool. As a ranged action, he targets all opposing characters within that range, regardless of line of fire. And hit targets can't make attacks during this action. Whoa. That's crazy. This is 37A, by the way, so which means we will have either a different Professor X as a prime, a rare prime, or we will have a different character, similar sculpt, just like how we've had Hammer and Wizkid. So maybe another wheelchair guy. I don't know. I would think it's another Professor X. This is a very old school Professor X. Maybe we'll get the 90s Professor X with a nice little glider. That'd be pretty dope. It's kind of crazy. They're really jipping us a little bit on the keywords, man. It's great. He's an X-Men. Love it. But a lot of us love, especially like in my shop, we love generic keywords. So scientists have been great. I don't know what else really you can put besides scientists. But anyways, but that's kind of like X-Men I understand, but I guess this is more so the original Professor X. He's got the blanket over his lab, so it makes more sense that he does have X-Men and nothing else tied with X-Men. But it's just kind of sad to see just one keyword there. We got in cap defend. So if we look, he's got the white box. Really good points, I think, for what he does. I mean, he's not a deep dial, but 75 and 50. I mean, 12 attack with in cap, and he's got that white box on the first three clicks. That mind control uses as a range action, charges all opposing characters within range, regardless of line of fire. So using that mind, man, shooting through characters, and you're just hitting them all. Targets all. You're gonna make everybody hit each other. That's so cool. He's gonna be great to just toss on a team, especially for the 50 points. You're gonna have an outwit, which he could target through characters with as well. The thing you have to use against this guy, man, is some stealth, hindering, because I guess regardless of line of sight for the hit targets for that, that's going to be the problem with your stealth won't work, but at least with the outwit and stuff like that. That one, man, that's that one, line of fire, no line of fire need there on hit targets, and then Kamek attacks afterwards, brutal, man, brutal. He's even worth starting at 50 points. I mean, I don't care. That's you would take that to the bank. I don't care what people say about that one. That's a really good Professor X. I'm actually blown away how good that is. And it's a rare. I mean, rares have been stepping up lately. I feel like you're making crazy uncommons. Good God, man. When we played yesterday, Jane Foster, she's like, we're talking about, like, someone just really loved Jane Foster. They gave her a million, like, positive things. In Dom, 30 points. Avengers keyword. Asgardian keyword. She's able to not be targeted by higher points than 75 or whatever. Her support, her defend is just ridiculous. So we're seeing like a big creep, you know. We got that Cable in the X-Men set. It's just bananas. Alright, Jean Grey. This looks very bland and basic. X-Factor, which again, we don't got ATAs anymore, but this is the way they're going to give us ATAs. Also don't like, just says X-Factor. I get it, this is Jean Grey in her X-Factor outfit. She's part of the X-Factor, but still would be cool to get X-Men in there, or whatever else, because this Jean Grey has been in the X-Men, and also, you know, I don't know if they're going to have Xavier School or whatever it's called, whatever they feel like doing. It's kind of just, I don't know, not the greatest for me that they're so... This Jean Grey, I haven't read it right now, but this Jean Grey, let's say, is just amazingly good with this one trade that's up here. It's not going to be worth playing on an X-Men team because you're breaking theme. When all, you know, people are, you know, all your whole team is X-Men, it's just, I don't know. I don't really like it that much. But when this character hits with an attack, modified damage plus one for each five in the attack roll. I think it's kind of weird, this five thing they're doing. I feel like they're running out of ideas. Cool. I mean, that's all right. She doesn't deal a lot of damage, so it's not crazy. She's only 60 points. I do like leadership. Kind of odd. I mean, I get it. She does take the leader role from time to time. Super sensitive sidestep. Not bad. I mean, TK's, I feel, is a huge thing lately. Kind of odd to throw Pulse Wave on her last click. Kind of like it's just a last hurrah, I guess, before you're about to die. I think it's kind of pointless to throw it on there. But I do think she's, I don't know. This one I'm a little split on. I think she's a little overcost. I think she's about a 50-40 click. That X-Factor just seems to be a trade. Again, without ATAs now, we get these trades. So all the X-Factor will have that. And then what else are you giving me? You're giving me sidestep. She's basically there for TK. No Indom, you know, I understand that. Only defense I have is super senses, and she has leadership. So the biggest benefit for me here is leadership and the TK. Both things that I could utilize, but 60 points on an X-Factor team? I don't know. I mean, I would be iffy with her on an X-Men team, but now with X-Factor, I mean, we'll see. I mean, we're going to get other X-Factor pieces, but we'll see. All right, finally. So, I guess yesterday, I was looking at Dark Beast. I think I called him a super rare. Apparently, it's a Chase, and that's... I don't know if I'm okay with that. I was going to say that's okay. I don't know how I feel, because I don't like... This is like what they did with the zombies. We got it in Galactic Guardians, then we got it in Deadpool. I mean, it's... I don't know. I don't know if I want more Age of Apocalypse. I mean, there are a lot of cool characters left. We still, of course, like we see in the picture alone, we have Cyclops, and you know, there's just a bunch of other people. Like that Gamma, the Externals were in there. All kinds of Age of Apocalypse things you could do, but I just don't know. Like, I'm already on the fence about another X-Men set. I'm like, my shop is called Best There Is. I'm like the biggest Wolverine fan. My son's name is Logan. I mean, I'm a huge Wolverine fan, but I can tell you when it's like oversaturated. And I just, at this point, I'm like, man, we're wanting an X-Men set, and now we're just getting tons of X characters. Deadpool had ton of X-Force, some X-Men. It was just crazy bananas. And then now we got this set, and I mean, I'll take whatever, because I love playing clicks, and I love new clicks because they're different. you know, get different cool fun powers, but the fact that we're just doing the same people over and over and over. So maybe with Age of Apocalypse, it'll feel a little different, but at the same time, I'm kind of bummed out that that's the chases. We'll see. I mean, Harley really surprised me. I love the chases in Harley. I still need a couple more, but I mean, I got the ones I mainly wanted. Thor blew me away with their chases. They're really fun and cool. I think even the worst chase in that is still playable. But we'll see how this goes. So we got Age of Apocalypse again. And is that just... almost looks like this is X, not... no, it's X-Men. It's just because it's so many words. When Angel is damaged by... I'm like an old person pulling out your glasses like that. It's like when I'm close to things, I feel like I can read it fine. But I guess this one feels a little more farther away. But this one I will try to tackle. I don't want my glasses on. It makes my head... it's too early for all this. When Angel is damaged by an opposing character, give that character a revenge token. Holy crap. So, I'm not even going to get into this, read the whole thing. This is what happens with Beast. They're all going to have this. Survivor of the Age of Apocalypse for now, which is when they die. How many revenge tokens they have, they can roll a die each time and they can give out that damage. Kind of odd, but okay. Well, I'll take it. Okay. On his feet, but I should say wings, his sidestep, stealth, shape change, but only if Angel is not adjacent to a friendly character. That's interesting. I like the sidestep, I like stealth, but that's kind of a bummer not being adjacent, because having that flyer, you know, when you got that guy to kind of drop you in somewhere, or if you're both gonna go in hindering for stealth, it's a nice little setup. But I guess you probably would just sidestep away so you can use shape change if you're in that issue. And if you're in, I mean, you're flying, so I guess in hindering you can still move your full sidestep. But yes, I mean, that's not bad. It's actually not bad. I think it's okay. It just sucks if you have anyone that's like gives you pluses for being adjacent or something. All right. Trying to set things right. Stop. So we got a stop click. Free. Deal 3 damage to each other characters. 3 damage to each other character within 5 squares and destroy each piece of blocking terrain within 5 squares. And then deal Angel 1 avoidable damage. Okay. So I don't really like that. I'm all for sometimes when we got these like clicks that are time bombs. But like, if it's penetrating damage, or actually, if it's, I want to see, you know, damage that can't be ignored, I guess. Doing that to characters within 5 squares, and then you're killing them. I mean, I don't know. He's 60 points, which isn't bad for what he does. I mean, that the sidestep, stealth, shape change is alright. He has no range. Charge would have been better in there instead of sidestep, I believe. He does get charge way later in his style. With the stealth and that shape change ability would have been nice to just have charge in there. Perplex is always good, but 60 points is, I think, a fair amount for what he does, minus that ability. God, that's god-awful. So, I mean, at that time, you might as well not even do that. Just attack. You have 11 attack. But, God, I don't know. 3 damage to each character. And, I mean, if that character has Imperv, they can roll out of it. I would assume Super Senses would still work with that. If he's giving 1 avoidable to himself, he should have gave 3 unavoidable to the other characters. I think that's a fair trade-off. Other than that, I think this chase is pretty crappy. I really do. It looks badass in the sculpt. I mean, granted, I don't know if it's going to look that good when it comes out, but I think this is a really bad chase. Don't get me wrong. I know, like, I actually had this discussion yesterday. You're not going to get mind-blowing chases that are all every time that there's a bunch that are just crazy and, you know, a amazing, and some are just gonna be eh. This one's really eh. It just feels like this should have been an uncommon. I mean, take away that trait and then give him whatever he has, and that's basically uncommon or rare. So this would be for me, if I got a case, which I will, because I just want more of everything. If I pull this chase, I would be beyond upset. Again, he's got okay stats and stuff. Like, I don't think he's like horribly bad for 60 points, but just for the power level of what the other chases may do. And on the other hand, Beast wasn't like crazy either. Beast was like, I think, like for me, mediocre. Like, okay, it wasn't bad. But it wasn't like, oh my god, I need this cool sculpt again. But that's not gonna cut it for me. So I don't know. So it looks like we have Age of Apocalypse chases. I don't know what else we could see for that. But we already got Kitty Pryde for the store, the opens, for the stores that run the opens. So we should at least notice that we're going towards more Age of Apocalypse. So, I mean, it's time to bring out our books and start looking through who could be next. I almost guarantee Cyclops will be in it. I almost want to bet down that he will be actually the one people will want. Number one, he's got the awesome 90-ness all over him. The long hair, the cool one eye showing. A really cool, goofy suit, but it's, I see him being good. He's going to have a good prime range attack, leadership, all that good jazz. And he'll probably be a good X-Men character as well, because he'll probably have Age of Apocalypse and X-Men. I doubt they'll give him Factor X or anything like that, because they're just giving them all Age of Apocalypse. But this is making me hopeful that we'll get another Apocalypse and maybe a better one. But I would like to see Young Apocalypse Genesis, which I could almost guarantee we'll get in this, because the set deals with the school, even though it's not the Jean Grey school, because that's technically where he went. But hoping we'll get that, and hoping we'll get Kid Omega, a newer Kid Omega. We have Wolverine and the X-Men's Kid Omega. I feel like he's been through a lot more things for us to get a new one. But anyways, yeah, so I mean, that's it. Looks like Age of Apocalypse are the chases. Place your bets. Let's see what, you know, people think about who's going to come next. I don't expect them to spoil any chases for a while, but I mean, we already got two back-to-back days. It's they're not hiding these chases anymore. It used to be a huge mystery, but now, like on Harley on the back, we had all of them there, and then Avengers Defenders, they're all in the back there. I remember I was like, I don't like this. I can see all the chases. It wasn't that much of a mystery. But again, I guess it's good for us to know what we're getting into. So maybe they will. Maybe next week we'll get another chase review, preview from a store and stuff. This is crazy. Like, you know, Eternal Games got the hookup, and now we have two chases down, I'm guessing, out of the six or eight. So let's see who's next. Like I said, crack open your books. Go to your Wikipedia pages. Let's see who we can figure out who's going to be next. Till then, take it easy, guys. I know my opinions might suck, but I try. Peace out.